up a feast from the farmer's market, you'll want to take a little break before dessert, or not. Here with a couple of creative outdoor games you can DIY with things found at the thrift store is Goodwill's DIY guy, Gary Foy. And in fact, welcome. Hey,
thank you.
The first thing does not involve a break before dessert, right?
No, it's go right to dessert.
Let's do it. What is this?
So what I got is it's a s'more station, right? Mm-hmm. You got fall, summer's ending, and the idea is to be able to put this together, leave it outside under a patio or apartment living, and then anytime you come out those long or short summer nights, you can have s'mores ready to go.
Because it's all ready. You don't have to do anything.
It's all ready.
So, I love this idea.
So why don't we get ready?
Let's do it. What do we do?
So we're going to start. We're going to do traditional. So you've got a couple different kinds, chocolate graham crackers and regular.
Okay. I'll take regular this time. But I love that you brought both kinds.
You got to bring both.
Yeah.
And then we're gonna do chocolate.
Of course.
Now, I think you need a whole bar.
A whole bar?
I'm gonna double chocolate.
And you can get dark chocolate or anything you want.
You can do whatever you want. The great thing about all this is if you keep it, you know, near your patio or whatnot, it's always ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Did the jars come from Goodwill?
You know, that's a great question. All of this came from Goodwill.
Wonderful.
So if you're looking to stretch your dollar and you want to make s'mores, well, mm-hmm. come on down to the Goodwill. You know, it would take probably 9 to 15 different stores to have what we have as a selection.
Isn't that something?
It's amazing.
And something like that's going to cost, what, $15, $20 at a store at Goodwill? That's maybe
$2.99 a jar.
How many marshmallows are we doing?
You know what? Let's do, I got an idea.
Okay.
Let's do the pokers. And the pokers are fun because you're safe. And I'm gonna go two marshmallows. Why don't you grab?
Two this way? I've got two over here.
Okay, good.
Here.
And the idea is when you're doing marshmallows, remember they're sugar, right? Mm-hmm. I'm not Alton Brown, but I know that if you roast them too much and they pop and they ooze everywhere,
good for some,
but I like to go slow a little bit. So we're using Sterno today, right? Sterno is clean burning. And it's nice because it's in this terracotta pot. Got it from Goodwill.
And that's fine. That's all we need.
That's all you need.
Control the heat.
Yeah.
You've got some rocks in there.
Yeah. Keep it level, and they burn pretty quick too.
Yeah.
And it's clean burning. It also is really nice because you can have them all year round. You don't need to have a fire pit if you're living in an apartment or something, right?
Right. Just put this on any kind of patio.
Yeah.
Right?
Any kind. I'm gonna catch mine on fire. I always do.
I do
okay,
too.
See,
if you don't get it a little on fire, you can't get it to melt.
So you just keep the Sterno level, and you know marshmallows are sugar, so you want to just mm-hmm. toast them up. So I think I'm pretty good. And what I like to do is I like to use these fondue pokers because everybody gets a color, and so if you have people over, the young ones over, you know you can do it that way as well. The thing is with fire too, if you're having young ones, you want to go over all the safety stuff and all that as well. So you give it a pull.
Oh my goodness.
And then you give it that, and then you're good to go. Oh boy, here it is. See it? See how it's all gooey? I'm gonna take a little bite.
I think I have to bite the little marshmallow blob
off. Yeah, I got the marshmallow blob too. And I make a mess, of course.
Look at that.
I'm gonna give you one of these.
They're so good. Oh my gosh.
So it's really easy.
I don't wanna toot my own horn, but my marshmallow is perfect.
Came out pretty good.
Yeah, it really is.
Came out pretty good.
Yeah. So 1, 2, 3 Sterno cans, some rocks, an old pot.
Yeah.
Have these guys out for a station and you're good to go. I like the way you roll. Okay,
hey,
what's next?
You. All right, I'm gonna blow these out real quick.
Take another bite of this.
Actually, I'm gonna cap them off.
I can't talk now.
No, keep it going.
Marshmallow.
We can always make another one too. Yeah. One for the camera guy, why not? All
right. Okay, I'm good to go.
So the idea is you have the adults and young ones doing this too. Maybe mm-hmm. have a couple of beverages with it. But then you're like, hey, maybe do some fun times outdoor games for, you know, adults or the young ones. So I put together this ring toss. Now it's glow in the dark, right? Because the summer nights are getting shorter.
Oh, good idea. So you put glow in the dark tape on those?
Yeah, I did glow in the dark tape and glow in the dark stars on it. I just took a basket I found on the Goodwill sales floor, hit it with some black paint, got all mm-hmm. those bottles there, and now you got a ring toss. And if you use these little glow in the dark rings, guess what? You can play ring toss in the dark.
That's
good.
So cool. And this costs almost nothing. And you know what these things cost? I went to buy some backyard games.
Yeah, yeah.
And yeah, they're really expensive. The cornhole tosses and these just make your own.
Yeah, this is super fun. It's DIY. I'm DIY Gary. Come on. I'm an amateur. I love doing this. So let's go.
What's
you go
thing?
First. Let's see if we can get this going. Almost.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. We're not even close, but we're trying. The effort is there.
Way harder to yell.
No!
You almost got it. You got it. You win. You hit a bottle.
Hey,
that's
thank
better.
You.
Those things don't fly very well. We might make them bigger next time
so we
can cheat. And then you have tic-tac-toe over here.
So, you know, we're sticking with the fall theme here. And I found this table It was a Lego table, you know, those little Lego tables. And it was kind of a little bit chipped, so I just pulled it off, hit it with some spray paint, put on some electrical tape, and then grabbed some gourds and some pumpkins and little pumpkins, because they're everywhere right now, and did some X's and O's.
And that's all you have to do.
That's all you got to do.
That's amazing. So part of it is just being able to see past the condition sometimes of the things you're looking at.
Yes.
Like if it's just chipped or it's not the color you want, big deal. You can paint it.
Yes.
So do you have ideas in the store? If we come into Goodwill, are there ways we can kind of learn, just ask the people who are there?
You can totally do that. You know what I like to do personally? I'm a Google image and Pinterest guy. I'll be honest. You know, I'm an amateur. I do this for fun at my place.
Right.
So what I do is I like to have a couple ideas, and then sometimes I'll Frankenstein them together, make a list, and then I go on into the store, and I have a good time and just try to put
it
together.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
And we know what the traditional outdoor yard games are and the things that you can buy prefab, but honestly, you know, you look at them, they're not that complicated.
No, they're not. And the other thing about building stuff on your own is you feel good about it when you're done. You're like, I built that, you know?
Right. Yeah. And the fun of it is it can match your colors or anything you want. So what do you think is the most surprising thing we can find in Goodwill?
The most surprising thing? I'm going to say that they probably put out about almost 10,000 items a day at the Seattle Goodwill.
What?
Yeah. So if you come down there, you're going to have a new fresh floor every single time.
Every day.
And that amazes me. Because I'm out there, you know, I go out there on my lunch a lot, I'm always buying stuff, and I'm always finding brand new things, and I know they're rolling stuff out constantly, and I think that's pretty cool. I don't know if a lot of stores can keep up with us doing that. You know?
Well, that's good to know, because I know people who just absolutely swear by the Seattle store, especially for clothing, because there's such great stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yes. So
anybody who brings s'mores is automatically welcome back
anytime. Thank you.
We'll link you to Goodwill's Facebook and Instagram pages where you can check out more of their great DIY projects. It's a very fun place to look for ideas. And then after the break, truly affordable kitchen remodels. What are all about the home show continues.